This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to put together two components of the operating budget for a manufacturing company, the selling and administrative budget and the budgeted income statement. So we're going to start with the selling and administrative budget. First of all, it provides an estimate of all of the operating costs other than production, and we'll talk about some examples in just a minute. I'll show you a slide that has some examples. The budgeted income statement provides an estimate of our profit for a given period, meaning it provides an estimate of our revenues and our expenses and the resulting profit. It's typically prepared using the accrual basis of accounting. So let's take a look at the selling and administrative budget on the next slide. Before I get into the details of the selling and administrative budget that you see here, I should remind you that the budgets that you see in this lecture tie very closely to the budgets that I present for the same company, Jerry's Ice Cream, in several other lectures. So take a look at those as well to see the complete set of operating budgets put together by Jerry's Ice Cream, including the sales budget, the production budget, direct materials budget, and so on. But this video focuses on the selling and administrative budget along with the budgeted income statement. So what you see in this slide is the selling and administrative budget for Jerry's Ice Cream, and it's for the year ending December 31st. It's prepared quarterly in this example. We could have done it monthly, but we chose to do this quarterly, and that's what you see here. The first quarter is January 1st through March 31st, since their fiscal year is the same as their calendar year. So again, the first quarter is January 1st, and then it goes out 3 months, all the way through March to March 31st. Then the second quarter is for April 1st through June 30th, and you can see the third quarter here along with the fourth quarter. And then we also have a summary of this budget, selling and administrative budget for the year. So what do we have in here in the selling and administrative budget? Well, we have salaries. These are all the operating costs of the company. So all those costs outside of the production facilities and production process related to Jerry's Ice Cream. So we have salaries here, and I'll just give you some examples of what these salaries might be related to. It could be that these salaries relate to our accounting personnel within the company. It could be for our marketing personnel within the company. It could be our computer support group within the company. So those are the types of costs that you'll see here in the selling and administrative budget. And what we're doing is estimating what these costs will be for each quarter. And you can see those costs. So for the first quarter, we think that our selling costs will be about $40,000. We also have rent in here in this example. There are many more costs. These are just a few examples. It could be the rent on the building where we house our accounting personnel. It is not rent for the manufacturing facility. That would go elsewhere. That would go into manufacturing overhead. But this is rent for the facilities that house our accounting personnel. Maybe it's our human resource department. It's the rent for that building. Advertising would also be a part of this budget, along with any depreciation that's associated with the long-term assets that we have within those departments that I just mentioned. Again, all of this is outside of manufacturing. And then we just have the kind of a catch-all other category here as well. But these are the quarterly costs that are associated with our selling and administrative areas of the company. So the selling and administrative costs that we'll see on the next slide on the income statement will be related to this line right here. The total selling and administrative costs, this line right here. And then what you see at the very bottom, so we'll see that on the next slide. Then what you see at the very bottom here is the adjustment that we need to make to get to the actual cash payments for selling and administrative costs. And those cash payments are going to be needed for the cash budget, and that's provided in a separate lecture. But you'll see the $55,000 here quarterly and the $220,000 for the year. You'll see that in a cash budget that's a separate lecture. So here we're going to focus on total selling and administrative costs, and that's the number you see here on this line, the $58,000 per quarter. And in total, the $232,000. Now we'll take a look at the budgeted income statement for Jerry's Ice Cream. And since we just left the selling and administrative cost budget, let's focus on this line to start so I can tie the two in before we go to the other information that's in this budget. On the previous slide, you'll notice that our budgeted selling and administrative costs totaled $58,000 for each quarter. And so that's what you see here on this line, $58,000 for each quarter, and it was $232,000 for the year. So that comes from the previous slide, from the selling and administrative budget that we looked at on the previous slide. The other information that you see here comes from the other lectures that I've talked about. So if you go search for those lectures for Jerry's Ice Cream, they all tie together. And you'll see, if you look at the sales budget video, you'll see these numbers right here and where they come from. So we're projecting, I'm just going to go right to it then, that I'll let you take a look at the separate video for the detailed information. But we'll go right to the number here. For the first quarter, we expect $240,000 in sales revenue. For the second quarter, we expect $288,000, and right on down the line. And then collectively for the year, we expect $1,200,000 in sales. Then we have our cost of goods sold amount here. And the cost of goods sold amount is going to be, as you can see at the very bottom, the footnote at the very bottom here, it's going to be the per unit cost that we figured out. Actually, it's right here. I'll come back to it and describe it in more detail. It's the per unit cost of $4.50 per unit times the number of units sold for each quarter. And I give you the example for the first quarter that it's $4.50 per unit times the expected sales of 40,000 units. So let's take a look then at this information right here, the cost of goods sold calculation per unit. If you go to my video that discusses, they're all in one video, direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead, and how to establish those budgets, you'll see at the bottom of each of those slides, for each of those budgets, the calculation for direct materials per unit, for direct labor per unit, and manufacturing overhead per unit. So you have to take a look at that separate lecture to see where that information comes from. But that's why we calculate that per unit information, because we need it here to figure out the cost of goods sold in the budgeted income statement. So I've described how to find the cost of goods sold for the first quarter already, and you'll see that in the bottom footnote down here. But that's where the information comes from. So you have to kind of piece it together. This is a culmination of lots of different budgets. The budgeted income statement is a culmination of lots of different budgets. So we take the cost of goods sold amount that you see up here, and I'll just look at the first quarter, subtract it from the sales revenue, and that gives us our projected gross margin, often called gross profit. And it gives you the gross margin for each quarter and collectively for the year. Then we take, we'll go right over here to the year column, and we'll take then the $300,000 in the gross margin for the year, and the same calculation for each quarter, but we'll take it for the year and subtract our selling and administrative costs, and that gives us our projected net income, both quarterly and here, the one I'm looking at, for the year. So this is what the budgeted income statement looks like for a manufacturing company.